Yes, I cannot tell you exactly where I'm at, and I couldn't pronounce it if my life depended on it. But we stopped. I got a Sprite, some stuff that I have no idea what it is, and I can't read the package. But I'm going to try it. But look at the mountains. It's so pretty. I'm having fun with my little tour group. This is a little rinky-dink gas station we stopped at, but it has lots of stuff. It's nice. And hey, they had clean bathrooms, they had Sprite, chips, espresso. And now I'm getting back on the bus because it's cold. But I hope everyone's having a good time, because I am.
I like the fact that they actually have a cover over this, so I think that's pretty neat. So, look at there. I have a clean top. I wish they did this in the States.
Against the Crusaders in 1187. And his grave is, you see the green couple? It's his grave. The story is, you see, that's the Annunciation Church, you see? Huge, like a lighthouse, you see? You see it from all over. The story is that at the end of the 90s, the Arab people from here, they wanted to build a mosque which would be bigger than the Annunciation Church. They got the permission from the State of Israel at that time, but then you know who came and said no? The Pope. He said, if you're going to build a mosque which is bigger than the Annunciation Church, then I will look that no pilgrims will come to Nazareth. And that would be the end of Nazareth, because they live on the people who come and buy and come and visit the Annunciation Church. So the State of Israel, we withdraw from the permission, and they could build it, and it stayed. the church from Crusaders' time.
Like some safe construction right there.
We are an hour behind schedule and traffic is very slow. Gotta have some mad traffic driving skills over there.
Thank you.
very hot, then 37 degrees, then magnesium, calcium, with all those things. And here were seven of them. Today it's only five of them left. Here happened the multiplication. Remember the wonder with the two fishes and five loaves bread? That was enough to feed 5,000 people. A wonder. The mountain where all the blessed were. Remember, blessed are the poor people, blessed are the people. Remember the eight blessed? This was the mountain here. And this they came back down, and here happened the wonder. Fifth century after Christ, and again a wall of the Crusaders. Again the same story. Something was here. The first to build the church, Byzantine time, 5th century after Christ. Then Sasan and Muslim destroyed everything. Crusaders built again. And then the Mamluk destroyed. And this church was built in 1980. The beautiful mosaic, which you will see from Byzantine time, they show animal and they show even a nilometer. Nilometer, which tells you how far the water is in the Nile. Why the Nile? Why needles? We are not in Egypt.
Thank you.
treatment, the purifying bath, which is very Jewish. Whatever you find this, you know that you're going to. Also the symbols. It's the menorah, the seven branches, the symbol of the 7 days, 6 days work, 1 day. This is the entrance of the Holy of the Holy. It's the scribe, how it should look. It's Yochim Boaz, the entrance. And this is the Holy of the Holy. Why the Western Wall is closed? Once a year, alone into the Holy of the Holy. Then you see wine, the symbol of the David star. You know, it's also a symbol and a very old symbol. People who believe would say David had it already when he fought against Goliath. But actually, as a real Jewish symbol, it was given in the 15th century after Christ from the king of Czechoslovakia. The Czechs allowed the Jews, they asked him if they can use it as a Jewish symbol, and he said yes. And it is the same with the symbol of the nuts, you know, the cross in the other direction. It's not an invention of Mr. Hitler.
Jordan River, and it is cold and people are getting baptized, and it would have been so awesome, but I didn't think to bring clothes, so I can't, but hopefully I'll get to come back. Wow. A place where didn't stick my hand in the water where he was. And it's like the most precious thing to have something so, so great. And all of these people around us are being baptized. So, yes, I definitely want to drench my water. My hands in the water. I'm so nervous because I'm so happy that I get to touch my body with the water that touched Jesus.